He's back, everybody, and this time that beloved Beagle makes his debut as Millennium Snoopy, looking fetching with his party hat and horn, with plenty to toot about. Creator Charles Schulz, Snoopy, and the whole gang are set to celebrate a new century and the 50th anniversary of Peanuts. All of us at Macy's Parade have a special hello for Charles Schulz, who's recently been diagnosed with colon cancer. We wish him good health, a happy birthday, and of course, a joyous Thanksgiving.
By the way, Katie, Millennium Snoopy is the first of 13 giant balloons, and he's an awesome sight. If you'll remember in earlier parades, that whooping Walter Mitty captured everyone's imagination as an astronaut and even an aviator. At an age of almost 400, that's in dog years, this perennially young pup and the Peanuts gang made the Guinness Book as the world's most widely read syndicated comic strip. Millennium Snoopy is furnished by United Media.
And Matt, there'll be no doghouse daydreaming today. Snoopy's in full party mode, and there's plenty of him to party, by the way. Charlie, Lucy, and the gang would have to take the elevator 7 floors up to give this Snoopy a Happy New Year smooch.
Parade parties on as the Mike Miller.
Incidentally, hovering high above the Sesame Street float on his 9th parade appearance, it's Big Bird Balloon, furnished by Children's Television Workshop. The bouncing ball balloons reminds us that 2 generations of kids have learned their alphabet during Sesame Street's 31 years on TV.
Katie, we just saw the real Big Bird, who at 8'2" could rule the roost at making foul shots. By the way, Big Bird Balloon is 9 times taller than his favorite basketball player.
And that would be?
I am so glad you asked me that. Of course, it's Larry Bird.
Arr.
NBC's telecast for the 73rd annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is being sponsored in part by Cotton Incorporated. Cotton, the fabric of our lives. And by Morgan Stanley Dean Witter. We measure success one investor at a time. The stars of the NBC daytime dramas Days of Our Lives and Passions, and Mini-Me from the latest Austin Powers, Vern Troyer, plus Kevin Bacon and the Bacon Brothers when the parade returns.
Garfield's favorite form of exercise may be a brisk nap, but America's favorite fat feline manages to drift down Broadway for his 16th parade, making our chilled-out Cheshire Macy's senior balloon. I think he's ready for his holiday lasagna with all the trimmings.
Garfield, by the way, is furnished by Paws Incorporated, and he gobbles up some 19,000 feet, cubic feet, that is, of helium. No wonder he's the size of a fast food restaurant. And by the way, when he wants his food, Katie, he wants it fast, which explains his fondness for the microwave. His head is the size of 50 of them.
Garfield always leaves us with some morsels of wisdom. This year, creator Jim Davis Tabby says, never put off until tomorrow what you can eat today. I'll eat to that.
Down Broadway is a show band that could even make Garfield sit up and take notice. And here is the first bee balloon in the parade's 73-year history, creating a big buzz on the parade path. It's the Honey Nut Cheerios Bee, furnished by General Mills. The beekeeper in charge is Macy's balloon captain, Pam Barnes, and the whole Barnes family. They've made the Macy's Parade a holiday tradition for 4 years running.
Honey Nut's very much the bee next door. Clever and friendly, and his favorite food is, hello, honey. In fact, that his honey pot is big enough to hold 9,700 gallons of it.
I like that. Hello. Another factoid for you, Katie. This wings, or his wings, are longer than the combined height of B.B. King, B.B. Newworth, and Sting. fascinating.
Please, you're giving me hype. Since the bee is 20 years old this year and doesn't have a name, kids all over the country have until December 31st to come up with a name for this most becoming character.
How about Bee Arthur?
She can compete as well.
Behave.
Be quiet. Each member of the Silver Spirit Band from Petticoat Junction. Now, do you need some bunny to love? Check out the Nesquik Bunny. He celebrates all of today's bands as he marches to the beat of his own bass drum, the size of two grand pianos. He's furnished by Nestle USA Beverage Division.
And Katie, the Nesquik Bunny has had a pretty busy year hopping from country to country with a hop over in Hollywood to have his paw print cemented in history at Mann's Chinese Theater.
That's impressive. He really is quite the world traveler. Nesquik Bunny's flown to more than 100 countries. He himself is the size of a small airplane. Never tried. It's amazing that voice comes out of such a young girl. She really is phenomenal. Meanwhile, orbiting into the 21st century with a double booster rocket pack of his own creation, that self-proclaimed boy genius Dexter, furnished by Cartoon Network. As his many fans know, whenever Dexter has a problem, he turns to his fantastic bedroom lab where he comes up with a scientific solution for anything except how to escape his pesky big sister, Dee Dee.
And Katie, I guess our boy wanders up for a little interplanetary exploration in the year 2000. At his size, Dexter might just be mistaken for a fleet of 11 Mars Pathfinders hurtling through the Milky Way. And he is pumped up with enough helium to fly free of Dee Dee for as long as he wants, 21,700 cubic feet of it. That's more than any other balloon in this parade.
Dexter is kept on trajectory by Macy's balloon captain, Michael Giarrucci, who received a Macy's Parade Director's Award for his longtime contributions to this ongoing event.
Austin Powers nemesis Mini-Me, Vern Troyer, the Alpha Balloon, the cast of NBC's Third Watch, and from later today, Florence Henderson. Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade will return.
Now back on Broadway, he's killing me. Waving to the crowd is a character who gives 18 million readers and a ton of PBS fans something to cheer about. Having a wonderful kind of day is that adorable aardvark Arthur, furnished by Eden Toys. Arthur's all about childhood challenges like sibling rivalry and making new friends.
He's big, Katie, taller than the combined height of 17 of his third grade buddies. We're told real aardvarks chow down on termites and ants, but Arthur prefers pancakes, pizza, cheeseburger, and chocolate cake, and he has the waist to prove it. Size 62. We're talking feet.
And Matt, while we're talking feet, check out those sneaks. Each one's the size of two taxi cabs.
Katie, that international man of mystery himself would have to describe.
Okay, Matt, while we're talking clues, here's three. She's a smart puppy, she's blue, and she's headed this way.
All right, let me think about this. Could it be Blue herself?
Is that your final answer?
Yes, Regis, that's my final answer.
Blue's debut is brought to us by Nickelodeon. Incidentally, she's only the fifth giant female balloon in the parade ever.
And by the way, she's a smart puppy, guys. Those clues she left behind for Steve tell us why she's thankful today.
With us. Christmas for the all-new Captain Kangaroo, Big Bad Voodoo Daddy, Mambo King Lou Vega, and a number from the Broadway musical Ragtime, and Santa Claus, live here on NBC.
Katie, and now you're ready to celebrate another anniversary. Together again for the second time in Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, Jay Ward's Bullwinkle gives a moosey back ride to his flying friend, Rocket J. Squirrel, as they celebrate the 40th anniversary of the Rocky and Bullwinkle show, and they're furnished by Universal Studios, and they are classics.
Moosey back ride.
Like cute. It?
Yeah. And next summer, Bullwinkle will make his silver screen debut in the live-action animated motion picture, The Adventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle. Our dynamic duo will definitely need some handlers if they're going Hollywood. Right now, they've got 50. In fact, there are 1,000 Macy's employees just handling the balloons in today's parade.
You know where Bullwinkle went to college, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Wassamata U.
Exactly. They're proud of him there. I think his pal Rocky said it best. Bullwinkle has more brains in his little finger than he has in his whole head.
And here at Waukesha, Wisconsin's North Star Band as they march south on Broadway with... Meanwhile, Nickelodeon furnishes us with Rugrats, those TV babies who know all about life from a little one's view. Macy's first three-character giant balloon is the size of 20 playpens, leading the bunch that take charge child himself, Tommy Pickles, holding off for dear life, Tommy's bespeckled best buddy, Chucky, that lovable scaredy cat. And along for the ride, of course, Tommy's dog, Spike.
Well, you know, Katie, Tommy may be in diapers, but he really gets things done. As he says, a baby's got to do what a baby's got to do. According to Worrywart, Chucky, there's nothing to fear but monsters. The way Chucky sees it, when all else fails, cry. Those designer specs are wider than two bunk beds.
And Spike, well, he doesn't say very much, but he does take the babies on some exciting adventures like today's. Spike's snout is as long as a school bus. All in all, the fabric needed to create the Rugrats balloon is enough to make uniforms for 300 of today's marching band members.
And lighting the way for Santa's arrival at Herald Square.
Pirouetting down the parade line for the first time, hamming it up, hogging the spotlight, hamming it. It's Petula Pig, furnished by the John Deere Company, which provides the official balloon utility vehicles for Macy's balloons. Legend has it, you know, gang, that Ms. Petula's Swine Lake gets a slopping ovation whenever she performs it.
Hey, you know, word is also that Ms. Petula squealed with delight when her favorite recording stars performed today. Do you know which one that is?
Brothers?
Ah.
Final answer?
Yes.
No, I mean, please make that your final answer.
Actually, it would be quite a pig feat for any sow to fill Petula's slippers. They're size 13 and a half feet. She's being gracefully escorted down Broadway by Macy Bloom Captain Chris Meyer and her team.
I love this next story. Talk about creative finance.
All set to have a super-de-duper millennium is Balloon Barney, also furnished by Lyric Studios. The real Barney, by the way, will be roaming the U.S. and Canada on a two-year tour of the live show Barney's Musical Castle. If Barney weren't already a star, he might experience a little age discrimination in the workplace because he's 200 million years old.
But he looks pretty good, Katie, and much taller than any T-Rex in history. He's half the size of the Museum of Natural History, just two blocks up from the parade starting line. He's stupendous.
Red Hot Recording Stars, 98 degrees. Followed by Santa sledding into Herald Square when Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade continues.